Look, guys, we talk this red pill stuff. We pretty much say on these red pill things that, look, if the Wicked Witch of the West, which is the majority of the Western women, notice I don't say all, but you know, if just the majority of them are going to treat us differently, because, and I mean differently in a worse way, because of negative stereotypes that we don't flesh out and don't fit, we're going to leave them and we're not going to stay loyal to them. Then by the same token, we should not be looking at white society in the West treating us differently, and I mean worse, and then saying, oh, we're going to stay here and we're not going to leave, and Ahmaud Arbery was wrong and the McMichaels were right. No. See, when I tell you I'm pro-black, I mean that from the bottom of my black heart. When I tell you I'm pro-black male, I mean that from the bottom of my black heart and the depth of my black mind. If we're going to say this, then we actually are hypocrites, and this will give Wicked Witches of the West, and even more so, righteous women who happen to be from the West, ammunition to say that black men are a bunch of dot gam effing hypocrites. And I, for one, am not going to justify someone saying it about me. People are going to say it anyway. Someone will. But my job is to simply not make it truth. We don't control what others say for the most part. But we do control how true we're going to make the insults and the detractions with which they will come up. So, I'm sorry, gentlemen, but if you up here red pill and then you trying to exonerate the McMichaels, they got every right to say something bad about you. And here I'm going to say why. Well, it's just my opinion. I'm talking about the law. And if your feelings, okay, F our feelings. Okay, then F the McMichaels' feelings too, right? So what did the McMichaels do? Let me break it down for you. The homeowner, English, was in contact with a neighbor of the unfinished house, Perez. Perez saw someone maybe a week and a half or some short time frame before Ahmaud Arbery got killed. He saw a black man standing outside the home looking in, but he didn't even see him inside. He saw him outside. He saw the younger McMichael drive up, argue with the man, and then when the man looking in put his hand on his waist, the younger McMichael got nervous and he drove off. Came back with his father, the older McMichael, but the black man was gone at this point. Perez witnessed all this. Perez believes that black man was Ahmaud Arbery. He did not give a definite identification. So I'm not even going to say that it's a definite one. He said, I think it's Ahmaud Arbery. If this is the case, it shows that they have let or they have not cared about white folks looking at the house, whether they walk in or not. But when a black man stands in the driveway and looks in from outside, they got issue with it. That shows this. There's more. In any case, English said nothing was stolen from the house. The day that Ahmaud Arbery was shot, he said nothing was taken from there. So this means that under Georgia law, which calls for you to either have witnessed or have immediate knowledge of a felony before you can make a citizen's arrest, these two white devils, and I'm not with Farrakhan, so don't even say that, but I'm calling them that because of what they did. I'm sorry, white supremacist devils, specifically. These two white supremacist devils had speculation of a misdemeanor, not immediate knowledge, let alone witness of a felony. They had speculation of a misdemeanor. What they were trying to do was to kidnap him, according to Georgia law. The McMichaels have no expectation of self-defense. They were trying to kidnap somebody. Now, in Georgia, there are white criminals who have gone to prison for extra time because they hurt someone in order to avoid getting caught while they were committing a felony. You cannot commit a crime and then have an expectation of self-defense. And some white defendants have gone to prison for longer. Enhanced sentencing. Because maybe they were stealing something and someone told them, hey, put that down, and they knocked him over as they tried to flee. No, 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 no. And I as a judge would throw the book at someone like that. Not only did you steal the candy, you hit him to get him out of your way so you could run off with it. Okay, yeah, now it's a felony. Yeah, I'm gonna throw the book at you. You're going for the maximum number of days. So, anyway, point I'm making is that they didn't have what it takes under Georgia law to try to make a citizen's arrest. Now, they jumped out that car with the shotguns and they said, excuse me, sir. And they didn't point it at him. I still would say that Ahmad should turn around and run, because he's a black man who ain't committed no felonies. He's a black man being stopped by two white guys with guns. That's what happened. And there were three shots fired. If that's a shotgun, don't you have to cock a racket in order to fire a second time? You see, at the end of it all, white America's treating black people differently, and that's what this all comes down to. I'm all for being outraged when a black person commits a black on black crime. When you know about it, yes, that is an outrage based on the treachery. I've said this before. You have to be outraged when white folks do it and then walk off free. Like Betty Shelby. Like Blaine and Salmoni. Like Yanez. Like Pantaleone. These are the names of the officers who have walked free. Of course, like George Zimmerman, who wasn't even an officer. You have to be upset with them and outraged at the system that let them go. Because the system let them go. Daniel Holtzclaw didn't even commit murder. He's in for rape in Oklahoma. But stop and think about this for a second. When they convicted Daniel, he said, how could you do this to me? Daniel Holtzclaw had an expectation that a white jury was going to let him off the hook because he only raped poor black women. I kid you not. What I want you to understand is that just like we know that most of the wicked witches, well, we know the wicked witches of the West do have a hive mind. They think alike and they have expectations from each other. White America has a hive mind too. And just like Boom Shika, Bonquisha, and Sapphire have agreed that it is okay to take those of you who are thinking black men, non-idness, and treat you with contempt compared to how they treat idness, the same thing applies to white America. They believe that it is okay to do things to you. They would not tolerate anyone doing to them, especially if you do it to them. And that if they do it, they're supposed to be let off the hook. That's why they request jury trials. Zimmerman and Holtzclaw wanted jury trials and they got them. That's the reason for it. Now, in the case of Blaine and Salmoni, they simply were not even indicted. They're going to get away with this. They're the ones that shot Alton Sterling. Yanez actually went to trial. I don't remember if it was a judge or a jury trial, but Yanez went to trial and he got off. I think it was a jury trial. He's the one that shot Philando Castile. Muhammad Noor went to prison. Norris and Greenhouse in Louisiana that shot that white boy because they didn't know he was the actual young white boy, because they didn't know he was in the car. And it was the father's fault that his own son got killed, because the father was the one aiming the car as a weapon towards them black deputy marshals. They still went to Angola. Worst prison in the planet. I mean, in the United States. At least it was voted such a long time ago. That's where they went. So what I'm saying is that there's this understanding. It's a hive mind. At the end of the day, it comes down to this. America's treating you worse because you are black. This is actually even an older phenomena than Boom Shika and Bonquisha and Sapphire treating you worse because you're a thinking black man and you're not Idnis. But we all sit up and agreed that we have the right to leave one, but we're cowards if we want to talk about leaving the other, and we're emotional and not thinking with our brains if we actually say that the system, in order to be fair, has to treat them the way they would treat us if we did the same thing to them. Now, it's dumb of us to expect that, but it is not wrong for us to demand it. I mean, the law doesn't expect you to turn yourself in if you're a wanted fugitive, but they still demand it. The law does not expect you to willingly stay in the prison if you have the means to escape, but they demand it. If you escape, when you find an opportunity, then they're going to catch you. And when they do catch you, you're going to have extra time tacked on because of your escape. Now, they know you want to be free. What the law is saying to you is, once we've convicted you of something and imprisoned you, you are to deny your wish to be free, nigga. And if you don't deny it, we're going to throw less freedom at you. That's what the system says. What they don't expect you to do reasonably, they will still punish you for not doing. Well, we don't expect them to do reasonably. We should punish them for not doing. If you cannot fight them militarily, and let's be honest, black folks can't do that just yet, then why not leave? Because that's what you said you're going to do. Danielle done said, black women ain't going to change what we're doing to you till you leave. Then she found out we're leaving. Why is it that you're willing to sit up here and tolerate this crap from Massa, which is actually far worse than what Boom Shika, Bonquisha, and Sapphire are doing to you? Don't give anybody ammunition with which to call us hypocrites. We got to be fair about this. If we can leave the women that come from the same wombs as us, our natural counterpart, at least within the same nationality or the same Western cultural block, if we can leave that woman that would otherwise naturally belong with us, then why is it you cannot leave behind some subhuman rat bastard hypocrites that really think you're less human and therefore it is okay for them to do everything to you they would never tolerate you doing to them? Outright oppression. Matter of fact, don't even answer that. Not with me. If you've been doing this, get your butt right back on your channel and admit that the ones supporting Ahmaud Arbery are right and the ones supporting or trying to exonerate the McMichaels are wrong. End of story. Because even if Ahmaud committed felonies previously, that's not what he was doing this time. And if he had stolen a hammer like they said, which he didn't, that still would not have been the reason that they stopped him. Ahmaud did not die because of his criminal record. He died because he's black. End of story, nigga. Now, I hope that one day this message is not necessary anymore. And in the meantime, I hope it helps. Black heart, black mind, black out.